Hey guys, welcome to Sled Talk. Appreciate you guys tuning in. I would like to take a second of your time and introduce this season's title sponsor is Bikeman Performance. So they've decided to jump on board and help push the podcast. And if you're unaware, Bikeman is the elite level when it comes to aftermarket performance parts on your sled. So be sure to check out their site, link in the description. And without further ado, let's jump into the show.
Let the band play.
100K on the Patek Philippe, living life with no regrets. I can't designer when I get dressed. Hey. Summertime on winter fresh. Fresh. I put her legs behind her head. Oof. Night night she gonna bed. Bye bye. Every day it's a new test. I just keep chasing these checks. Living life with no regrets. Living life with no regrets. Living life with no regrets. Living life with no regrets.
Sled Talk listeners, welcome back to the next episode. Appreciate you guys tuning in. We have returning guest Shay Sainsbury and Jeff via FaceTime. Jeff is currently out of the office. So we are, between me and Shay, we're manning the cameras and the audio and the lights and the computer. And so bear with us. We are not as professional as, or semi-professional as Jeff is.
Yeah, I don't know how to do any of this stuff.
So we are sitting here in the office waiting for the 2024 Polaris SnowCheck reveal. So if you're watching this on YouTube, you can see we're doing a screen recording on the computer, and yeah, we've got, 7 more minutes.
Perfect. So that gives us time to figure out why I can't hear you in my headset.
You can't hear me?
I can't hear
oh,
you.
Oh, well, see, there we go.
You gotta go twist the jack.
Oh, boy, 5 minutes. I think this one actually works. It is working. Hey, Tyler.
Yeah.
We're good for right now.
You sure?
I can hear myself.
Perfect.
Just don't touch anything. Don't even look at it. Oh, dude. Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. We're good.
Hello? Oh no. Yeah. Now I don't have it in mine.
Oh, really?
Hello?
Hopefully
microphone
works.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, how's your... Can you hear?
Oh, yeah. I can hear now.
Holy cow. Well,
we got it.
More work for Jeff. He's going to have to edit all that out. Okay, now we're down to 4 minutes. So you were saying before you had cut out. Oh, that's what you were saying, was that you were cutting out.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
My gosh.
Yeah, you were doing the intro and gave us the time slot and then let you know that I was cutting in and out a little bit.
Okay. So we're back to it now. Hopefully, looks like all the cameras are still rolling. Jeff, you messed up on the height of your camera. That's on me. My head's chopped off.
Just a little bit.
Just a yeah. little bit. You can barely see the RSI on my hat. Dude, don't ever be sick again, bro. This is not okay. I think it's fine. I was just kidding. It's all right. I won't even use that one very often anyways. Okay, so 3 minutes. Hopefully it comes. It doesn't crash. These next couple minutes, do you have, Shay, is there any thoughts of what you think might be dropped? Anything crazy? Yeah. Maybe some things possibly a little bit better.
I don't know about crazy, but I'm going to speculate here. Looking at Polaris's Facebook 3 days ago, they posted with a caption, "Can you feel it?" We're 1 weekend away from dropping, right? And they talk about the 9R in there, and they talk about the boost. Those are the only two things that they talk about. So if you just
you
add
think that's
one plus one equals two, I hope, right? Hoping to get that boosted 9R.
You think so?
I hope so. That'd be pretty wicked.
Well, if I'd they do drop it. That, that's what we'll get Jeff.
Oh, 100%, yeah. It's only going to come in a 146 option, though, so you're really going to have to ride. Have a lot of fun.
That'll be death. What do you think of that, Jeff?
Probably make you boys look bad.
You probably would. I hope you do.
Oh boy.
2 minutes. This is agonizing 2 minutes.
So anything else comes to mind other than that, you think?
I've seen some chatter, I think, about like a different type of track. I know Skidoo kind of shifted their track a little bit. So I've seen some speculation on tracks out there as far as lug length, I think, or like different options for the lugs.
Okay.
So that'd be interesting. I mean, could you imagine like a 3.25 or like a 3.5-inch paddle? That would be insane.
Holy crap.
Lot. And that would add a lot of weight too. So they, I don't know. I doubt they do that. But who knows? What else could be different? I mean, they could narrow her up maybe a little bit. Yeah, I don't know, man. What do you think?
Dude, my mind goes completely blank. Like, I really haven't put too much thought into it. Just because, you know, like last year, so much with the 9R, like there was a bunch of new stuff last year. And so I don't know how much new crazy there'll be, but I don't know. And for me also, like, I am still on an Axis, mm-hmm. right? So I haven't spent very much time on a Matrix. So there's not, I can't really speak on like, oh, I wish they would change this a little bit to the chassis or, you know, so like, I don't really, that Axis is for sale, by the way. Yeah. both of them are. So I really don't know. I kind of just, I almost kind of intentionally didn't want to think of like what was going to come just because I knew that we were going to do this.
Yeah.
And wanted to just get a, you know, an authentic reaction to like, oh, so I don't, oh, it's 3:15. Polaris, your site's not going on here. What's up? Oh boy. I hope I'm in the right place. Oh, my phone's going off.
It's time.
Kobe just sent a DM. Oh boy. I don't even, he just asked me. He just asked me if I've seen it yet. And then he texted me something that looked like he had seen it. So I'm just not going to read that. It may not be anything, but I don't want to risk it. Oh, I just put Jeff down. Sorry, Jeff. Still there, Jeff?
Yeah.
Oh.
I was going to say.
Oh, introducing. Oh, there it is.
There it is, yeah.
Oh, boy. There was no video? There's the highlights already. Oh, my gosh. Look at these colors.
The color schemes.
Oh, boy. Snowcheck exclusive, the 325 Series 9 track. The all-new 325 Series 9 mountain track delivers instant lift, ultimate traction, and forward drive in the deepest and steepest conditions. Plus, all 2024 RMK models will feature the reversible scratchers to keep your engine cooler on the trails.
That's actually kind of nice.
Yep.
The little conveniences.
So you were right about the track. Colors. Okay, well, I was wanting the video. You think it'd be on YouTube?
Maybe.
Jeff, are you searching? Oh, there it is. 2 minutes ago. 2024 Snowmobiles Walk Around Mountain. Should we watch that one? That's probably it, huh?
My name is Nell Zide. I'm the Mountain Product Manager here at Polaris, and today we're going to talk about what's new for 24 on the best deep snow sleds in the industry.
That's a nice Rocky orange.
That, I was going to say, I like that one. That 9R's.
That's, yeah. Man, that's...
Now, when we talk about our RMK lineup, every single RMK delivers three things: instantaneous lift, effortless control, and immediate response. No matter which RMK you get, they deliver these three trademark Polaris attributes that make them work so well in the snow. The first is instant lift. When you start moving on a mountain sled, the vehicle needs to actually generate lift and pick itself up out of the snow. That way you can get moving forward. You don't want the track to sit and spin and trench through the snow. It has to lift itself right up on top. And that's what every single Polaris does. They're lightweight. The proprietary rear suspension design, drivetrain angle, all of our exclusive tracks, they generate lift up out of the snow. The second is effortless control.
Well, Skidoo just weighs over time.
You're not riding as well as you can be. The Polaris is light, compact ergonomics, and it's super easy to handle. Allows you to ride longer throughout the day and have more confidence to go ride technical terrain. And last is immediate response. When you make an input into the snowmobile, it has to react. In the mountains, things happen quickly, and the Polaris responds immediately. whether it's the flip of a throttle or a pushing down on a running board, the rigid chassis and predictable suspension delivers exactly what it needs to and listens to your command every single time. Matrix Slash is our purpose-built deep snow platform. This is our factory mod mountain sled that you get right from the showroom. So what makes Matrix Slash work so well in the super deep snow? The magic really happens here at the rear of the snowmobile. So the Matrix Slash features a shortened version of the tapered tunnel that all of our Matrix platform sleds have. It's 4 inches shorter than a Matrix standard tunnel. It's actually 7 inches shorter than a comparable Axis tunnel from the previous platform. So that keeps the vehicle up out of the snow. And you know, you've got an RMK on edge and you're really trying to ride in the technical. You look back and the tunnel's up out of the snow. It reduces the drag and it allows you to control the snowmobile better and maintain that forward drive. The second piece is the shortened centralized cooling system. So on a Matrix
Slash, the cooler ends
at the rear of the tank. What that does is the entire rear section of the tunnel doesn't collect snow and ice. There's no cooler underneath the tunnel there to build up that snow and ice. So that's real world weight savings when you're out in the mountain. It delivers a lighter sled on the hill that handles better and has better traction.
It's good looking colors.
All right, so both our Matrix and Matrix Slash platforms come in two personalities of mountain sleds that you get to choose from, the Pro and the Chaos. Now, the RMK Chaos is our wild child mountain sled, and it's purpose-built to be super dynamic, agile, responsive, and really fun to throw around. What makes the Chaos work so well? It's got a different rear suspension geometry that transfers more weight back, so it keeps the front end of the vehicle nice and light, super playful in the handlebars. And what that means is it does wheelies, re-entries, hopovers, things like that a lot easier because it's already transferring that weight back. When you're in the tight trees, it's a little bit easier to throw around, a little bit easier to move around just because that weight transfers back. And it's super fun to ride all over the mountain. If you want to do drops, jumps, ride in the meadows, ride some trees, ride some single track, the Chaos is the sled for you. The last piece with RMK Chaos is these Walker Evans Velocity high-low speed adjustable shocks. So they're a purpose-built mountain shock, so they're still lightweight. That's meant to give more adjustability for those people that really want to push the limits of the suspension. So high and low speed compression adjustment on the shock there. If you want to go do drops, jumps, single track, whatever it is, really dial in your ride. More adjustability and capability with the Chaos Velocity shock package. And then we have the Pro RMK. Debuted in 2011, the Pro RMK is the standby Polaris mountain sled that set the standard for what technical precision means
like
in the trees.
Color?
I
what
do.
Makes a Pro
I'd never
RMK
get it.
Work so well in that tight technical
I mean, all the colors
right.
you're all black.
Huh?
Well,
so
I've got
the lightest
specific
mountain sled in the lineup,
in mind,
starts at 419
you know, so
like, pounds, and features a really balanced
I don't really care.
Geometry.
I'm
going to
order
so
all black everything anyways. So
on a side hill,
colors are cool, but
through the trees or going up the hill, it stays balanced and predictable at all times. What that delivers is a new level of capability on a mountain sled that you can take it wherever you're willing to go. A couple Pro-specific features, carbon fiber overstructure, which helps keep the weight down and get us
like
to that 419 number, and then the shock package. So, comes standard with these Walker Evans monotube shocks. They're the lightest shock package that we have. High performance rebuildable shocks that maintain the lightweight. We do have a Velocity shock package from Walker Evans as well that's available on the Pro in snow
What's
check.
That?
So whether you want to go attack the tight technical trees and push the capability of the machine, or go do hopovers and wheelies, we got a sled for you. Now, the last choice with the RMK lineup is my favorite choice, the engine. So we've got four engine options in the RMK lineup. The first is the Patriot 850. Debuted in 2019, this motor is rock solid, lots of performance, lots of durability, and is available in season at your dealership in almost any RMK that we sell. We have the 650 available in our Pro RMK 155 in the standard Matrix platform. A great option for people looking for more fuel economy, something that's easier to ride. It delivers really smooth power and is available again in season. Here, we've got our SnowCheck exclusive engine options, which is our factory mod motors that we build for RMKs. The first is the Patriot Boost, and this is the Patriot 9R. The power and performance of these vehicles
9R
is
boost,
unmatched,
huh?
And something that aftermarket could only dream of a few years ago. All delivered with a 2-year warranty in SnowCheck. So we'll start with Patriot 9R. This is a race mod version of our 850 Patriot. It was developed with our hill climb team on the Rimshaw course and is a big bore 900cc naturally aspirated twin. It is all about lightweight response and lightweight power. It's a pound and a half lighter than an 850 Patriot, delivers 12% more torque, 7% more power, and has 3% less inertia. Now that inertia is really the magic. The motor is super low inertia and it responds instantly. It puts the power down and hits harder, faster than anything else on the hill, and it makes it easier to handle too. In an RMK, you're steering with the throttle and getting the track spinning all the time to help maneuvers, what? And the 9R spins up faster than anything we have. If you want to go ride tight technical trees,
oh boy,
the 9R is the ultimate weapon.
Jesus. You build one already?
And then here's our Patriot VR1. So this is the turbo. It's an 850 Patriot, and I want to talk about that for a moment. When we launched the 850 Patriot, it was supposed to be turbocharged. That was always part of the plan. So when it came time to build the turbo version of our 850 Patriot, all it needed was two more injectors and some pistons. Everything else is the exact same. It was designed to be turbocharged. That delivers durability like nothing else on the hill. It has years of durability and reliability validation before it was launched, as it was built as part of the Patriot platform. The second piece is what really makes this turbo work so well, and that's the control. So the turbo this system features our proprietary Smart Boost technology. And what that is it's an external wastegate that's actually mounted up on the tune pipe, and that's very unique in turbocharged applications. What it does is it unlocks a new level of combustion stability. That delivers everyday performance that runs perfectly every single time, no matter where you are. And the last part, the power. So it builds 10% more power than an 850 Patriot at sea level, and it carries that power level all the way to 10,000 feet. That means at 10,000 feet, it's making 50% more power than an 850 Patriot would. Builds up to 9 pounds of boost, and it's super rideable power. If you want to ride the tight technical trees, you can still do it. And when it's time to turn it up the hill and wick it up, it just hauls the mail. And new for 2024, we're really excited to launch our new Series 9 325 track. So it's a 3 1/4 inch tall lug built on our 3 1/2 inch pitch track platform. So the same dual extrovert driver and 3 1/2 inch pitch that's found on our Series 8 275 track. Now, when we set out to build a new track, it was all about lift. We wanted a track that generated lift and forward drive in the deepest snow that we could find, like nothing else that we had ridden. And the result is 325. You pair that with our proprietary lug design here at Polaris that we've built in the last 30 years, and you get the best deep lug track that we've ever ridden. So the other track that we'll have available for 2024 is our 275 Series 8. You might ask, should I get a 275? Should I get a 325? The reality is they both work really well. They're just good at different things. If you ride nothing but super deep powder and you want forward drive and all the power to the ground that you can handle, 325 it is. If you ride a lot of different snow conditions or you want the lightest, most agile and quickest track that we have to ride all kinds of technical terrain, 275 is the choice. For 2024, the 325 Series 9 track is SnowCheck exclusive. So it's available on 9R and Boost RMKs in the 155 and 165 length. The 325 Series 9 track is the most purpose-built mountain track we've ever made. It's uniquely designed for one thing, and that's traction.
We'll just go through everything.
To maintain the durability of the track, you gotta do two simple things when you're riding it. The first is scratchers down on the trail. For 2024, we've got new reversible scratchers standard on all of our RMKs.
Yeah,
they're a single coil reversible design, so you can back over them, way more durability, and they throw way more snow into the skid. What that delivers is better track cooling, which is key for 325 durability, and better engine cooling to keep your engine temps in check when you're on the trail. The second is keeping it under 50 miles an hour on the trail. So for 325 sleds, there will be a 50 mile an hour speed warning on both the message center and 7S display, letting you know that you're going too fast and you're putting the durability of the track at risk. You do those two simple things, you'll get to experience the magic of the 325 track for winters to come. And all our RMKs for 2024 will come with our new higher traction brake system. So two new pieces that are key here for the brake system for 2024. The first is a new brake rotor. So it's a little bit lighter, has some more venting in it, and it's all about maintaining durability under heavy use. The second piece is a higher traction caliper. So what that means is when the brake lever is all the way out, it's going to spread the caliper further apart than it did before. What that means for you as the rider is as you pull that brake lever in, you're gonna have more travel before you really engage the pads. It's just a little bit, but what it does is provides more fidelity and more feel in the brake lever, so you can control the brakes even better than before. So as you can see, the best deep snow sleds in the industry got even better for 2024. Factory mod motors are back with 9R and Boost, new level of instant lift and forward drive with our 325 Series 9 track, hassle-free experience with our new scratchers on all our RMKs, lots to be excited about. We can't wait for you guys to get out and ride them.
Mm.
Oh boy.
Oh boy. Well, let's go. Let's see what else they have for.
Let's see. They have the trail one on there too.
Do you want to watch that? We can watch the live.
Are they live right now?
Or I mean, like writing. Snowmobile summary. Saint Skinner, a couple other guys talking about the track. Oh my gosh, they
released a lot.
Holy crap.
Hey, what's up, guys? Hope you're enjoying the show so far. Just want to take a quick second to introduce another one of this year's sponsors. We got RSI. So whether you need handlebars or grips, seat covers, controls, etc., doesn't matter. Use Sledson 2023 at checkout for 15% off your next order.
Let's watch that one real fast. That was only 3 seconds. Guaranteed?
Did you see that?
I didn't read it. No, I was watching what it say. Guaranteed Ooh. To ship by November 30th.
Screenshot it.
Or you receive $1,500 off. Oh, boy.
That's going to be the talk of everything.
That's interesting. You see any other ones you want to watch before we kind of dissect and start building? And
yeah, other I think maybe if anything, yeah, watch the Series 9 one.
This one, the testimonials.
Either one, yeah, probably testimonials would be best.
I think the first time that people get on this sled, they're just gonna think that it flat out rips.
People are gonna be blown away with the deep snow performance.
It has a crazy amount of traction.
Right into the tree.
It's tailor-made for the guys who want to ride the deep and the steep.
Over the last 15 years, myself, Brant, Dan, a lot of us, we try stuff. We try different tracks.
In the past, some of the downfalls with deep lug tracks have been obviously the weight, durability, and the big one for me was trenching.
Typically,
I haven't seen that climb suit yet.
Have a reputation of or the helmet. Down.
When I first got the prototype last year, I looked at it and I said, well, this isn't going to work. And then my first day on the snow, I was like, holy crap, this thing goes forward and hooks and goes. And it just didn't have all of those pitfalls of what I've ridden in the past.
It has so much good drive out of the hole, which I would say is super, super crucial, especially for tree riders and guys that like to push themselves. Because once you're on top, you're on top. And this thing, it doesn't dig down, it just pushes forward. Going from a stop, building enough power to do a bow tie, land right back in a side hill, which your back end lands down, and then continue to go forward is super impressive.
One of the key factors in making a line or failing on a line is getting going, getting that momentum cranked up on the sled. And that's one thing that this track is masterful at, is that it literally has so much bite and so much grab, it doesn't trench. It goes forward first.
Big lug tracks have a reputation of not being the most durable tracks. There's two things that hurt these big lug tracks. One is speed, and the other is heat. From a speed standpoint, the 325 has got a exclusive 50 mile an hour speed rating. These tracks are specifically built to be off trail and in the deep snow. So slow it down and your track will live. What we're really excited about too that comes along with our 325 track and our other mountain tracks is the new Scratcher. The new Scratcher kicks up a huge amount of snow.
They work super, super well. Over the years past, we're usually running 30 to 40 degrees hotter on the trail than what we are now running.
That's
with the bigger track and
That's
the better
a substantial
scratchers.
Amount.
I love lightweight snowmobiles, and the new Series 9 325 is actually heavier than a 2.75 Series 8 track, but the benefits in the deep snow and in the more steep technical terrain, that ability for the sled to get on top of the snow even better and drive forward. The additional weight was a no-brainer for me with the performance on the snow.
It does not hum on the trail.
He's agreeing to the weight.
It doesn't vibrate like a lot of big tracks used to. It feels really rippy, and I can pretty much bunny hop it in the meadows. And it's so much fun because it has so much drive and so much bite. You can feel it biting and pulling you forward. So with the 325 track, I had a lot of preconceived notions based off the past. Man, was I wrong. It's working great, and it's got such good drive forward. It makes the track a lot of fun to ride.
It really thrives in steep technical terrain, deep snow, those conditions that we all live for. This is the one I'm going to be riding on my sled.
Like, it's crazy. Like, I went from, yeah, this is a really cool sled, but this isn't for me, to like, I'm totally getting one of these next year.
Interesting. That's probably pretty similar. Okay.
I think that's it, buddy. I think it's time to build.
All right. Well, snow check yours. Let's do yours first.
Mine first. Okay.
Switchback?
Yeah. Or the Titan. I'm pretty.
Here, do you want to control it?
Sure. Let's do it.
See what you come up with. Kind of just for the listeners that aren't watching, kind of, you know, maybe. tell everybody what you're picking as we're going through here.
All right. So definitely... staying away from the trail sled. So we'll go with the RMK. So there's the Pro RMK, RMK Chaos Slash. We're going to jump down to the RMK Chaos Slash. And let's see what else there is. Is that 650, 850, 9R, and the Patriot Boost, buddy. Mm. Going with the Boost.
Tracks.
I know, man. This one's kind of hard because I have the 3-inch lug already. My good buddy has the 275, and I feel like he carries a little bit more speed going through some stuff. But if I'm getting the new one, why not just get the new track too, huh?
So if a 155.
Yep, 155, 3.25, Series 9.
Okay.
Let's see what that's about. Ooh, that's looking good.
Colors.
So that's a... interesting color too. It's got that brown with the almost like a hunter orange and black. Then we have the high vis
and the like an green,
army green. But you guys watched the snow check event. I was pretty excited about that Tiffany blue and royal purple combo. I'm digging it. Tunnel color. They have just the raw tunnel black, raw tunnel or black, I guess. So going with the black, that still looks pretty sexy. And the rail colors, there's, what is that, black, royal purple, or that Tiffany blue.
Man. Plum crazy.
No, that's, there you go.
Okay. Right. Okay, yeah. Gotcha. Ooh.
Radiant green. I don't know, that's a hard one.
Ah.
Black looks pretty good, though. But... we're going to go with the Radiant Green. I think that's what that's called, right?
Yep.
Ooh, so this is another one that I always struggle with, right, okay. Is the manual start or the electric start, especially when I'm looking at, like, the price point of it.
Yep.
I always, like, take that macho route, like, oh, man, if I can't start my sled, like, I have no business riding it. Man, let me tell you what. There's some times where you're just, like, dog tired at the end of the day and you're stuck and you have to go start that thing and it's on a wicked side hill and you're like, bro, why do I have to pull this thing? Like, why didn't I get electric start?
Yep.
But guess what? I'm still going to go with manual start.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I'll still go with manual start this time. Penny pinch, I guess.
You don't want anybody in the comments blowing you up, huh?
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is. Yeah, they could if they had, like... no big deal. Perfect. All right. Mid smoke. So windshields, not a windshield guy. I know my hands get freezing cold sometimes, but hey, it's why they make thicker gloves and hand warmers, right? So the chaos boost has that Walker Evans velocity, high low, sticking with those because obviously that's what you get. Like that low pro taper handlebars. I can't remember what I actually have right now on mine, but I love like the whole setup that I have just ergonomically on there. I love, and I'm pretty sure it is this low pro taper handlebar. I feel like gives you a little bit more control. I think we're kind of past those, you know, 12-inch riser days. Yeah, I think.
I would say so.
We'll see. But go with that low pro. 7S display. I have to say, this is probably one of the coolest things that Skidoo's come out with. Not just because it's so big that you can see it, but
Skidoo has come out with?
Sorry, not Skidoo.
Whoa.
I think Skidoo's screen's probably bigger, but not all the time does that count, right? This screen actually... So it has the map already built into it, right? Like everywhere. And I can link up with anyone that has this 7S display. It doesn't even matter if it's like a general or a side by side or even a sled. So it's really fun. Again, my good buddy has the same one. We literally link up at the beginning of the day. And when we're mobbing through the trees, it's so easy to see like, hey, where's he at? Oh, he's side hilling. You know, right above me 50 yards. I can't see him, but I can see him on this. So, I don't know. It's nice. Pretty and then handy. When you don't see him moving for a while, you know, you do the radio check. Hey, how's it going? Whatnot. Yep. So, amazing. I'm a big fan of that. I talk it up quite a bit.
Oh, boy. Look at that. Just shy of $23,000.
No biggie, man. I wish. We'll see.
Oh, boy.
Covers. I always feel like a lot of people give me crap about not having a cover as well because I don't. I cheap out on that, but I think my sled would like it if I actually had a cover. Throw that cover on there. Protection, I'll probably go through third party for bumpers. The bag, I have a bag, so I'm going to go ahead and pass on those. But the bags are a lifesaver. Take some of that weight off of your back if you carry a lot of stuff in your backpacks. What's the performance? What is this? Handlebars, skis, carbides, electronics, belts. Can never go wrong with getting, what is that? A maintenance kit with it? Yep, got to stay up to date on that one.
Good Lord.
Yeah, there is so much stuff on this. I think I'm just going to keep it easy. I think that's the sled right there.
Yeah. What a beaut.
Yeah. Just going to soak it in for a second. Yeah, that's good.
Take a picture.
Yeah. I'm actually going to real fast.
Yeah, though.
Face ID decides to work. Oh, yeah. That's it. That's the ticket.
That's the one, huh?
Yep.
Next. Place order.
Next. I'm finished. 23,284.99, baby. It's not too much off of starting price. I think what?
Yeah, not bad at all.
Just the color adds a little bit of money. Yeah. That's it. Oh, boy. All right. Is this the part that I actually put in my name, or am I handing this back over to you?
I don't know. What are you going to do?
Yeah, we'll
are you
see.
Sure? It's already built and saved and ready to go.
I mean, worst case, it's only $500, I guess, right?
Yeah.
I don't know if they're on here?
Morrow County, yeah, they're up. Right there.
Oh, look at that, right there.
Shout out Justin at Morrow County.
Oh, I guess I got to enter my name and whatnot.
Oh, look at you. Hell
we'll
yeah.
We'll see. This isn't not official, folks.
gonna tease everybody like that?
Yep. Yeah. Oh, probably. Boy. Oh man, what is one of the most original?
Hey, that's all right.
Email addresses there are. I don't remember. 97844, I think, is. I want to so bad.
Oh, submit my snow check. Oh, done. Oh, my goodness.
We'll see. Wait. Why does it say ride now? I thought I selected Morrow County.
You did. Oh, no. That's not what we.
Well, looks like I'm going to have to talk to Justin myself.
Yeah, I got his number. I can get it. Why did it do that?
I'm not really sure.
Oh, I think after you put in the zip code, it changed it as the closest one.
Probably.
God.
That's all right. Maybe that's a divine sign from the big man upstairs.
Oh, boy. All right. My turn. What are we going to... Oh, that's...
That's actually a pretty sick color.
That's very pretty. So that's only for pro.
Assuming that's pro, yep.
Boy. All right. Snow check yours. My turn.
What do you have? So you have two pros right now, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. And I haven't spent much time on a chaos, but that's what we're going to do. Is an RMK chaos slash. Yeah. We're going to go with the boost. Bop. We are going to do, so this is kind of where I'm stuck at on the new track, right? Like, sounds epic, but, I mean, dude, how often are we, well, I mean, you ride a lot more different places than I do, but just the majority of my time, I'm just not in snorkel deep snow.
Yeah.
Enough that I don't know if I want to justify getting that.
I mean, completely understandable.
So I think I'm going to stay with a 155 2.7 Series 8. That's what I'm going to do. Side panel and hood color, black and gray, I guess, since that's all there is. Tunnel, black. Rail, black.
Murdered out.
Next, we'll do manual start, high elevation clutching. The wind deflector.
Yeah.
Because that's...
I don't know why they call it a wind deflector, honestly.
It's just that little piece really right there. Anything. Okay, next. Walker Evans. Yeah, we're going to take those off and replace them with some Fox shocks, but low taper handlebar, we're going to take those off and replace with some RSI handlebars as well.
There you go.
7S display. Saving your build. Boom, done. I will probably grab, where's the cover?
Like middle, very mid.
Covers right there, yep. Right there. Polyester, overnight, matrix, 3/4 polyester. Oh, so it doesn't cover the tunnel?
I think so. Which actually, that's, yeah. I'd honestly get that one. I kind of overlooked that one. But
what,
you don't really need your tunnel covered.
Okay. That is... That completes... That. It's kind of weird that it can't just be all black.
I know. It does kind of look a little different.
I don't like that at all. I mean, it's going to get wrapped anyways. And probably a helium hood, so...
Yeah, I think it'll still look sick in person.
That'll be gone. And no, everything else is going to be all aftermarket. So that's all I'm going to get from Polaris directly. Bop, bop, bop.
Oh, you're coming in a little cheaper.
22,256. I am finished. And my name is not Shay. Oh boy! Oh my!
Yeah, there it is. There's all my info.
All my info is popping. That's all right.
just so everyone else is aware, I do not check my Yahoo account. So if you spam me on it, never going to know.
I am not choosing right now. Morrow County. I am 18. I do not need that. Boom. Submit my snow check. Don, thank you, Tyler. Your request has been sent to Morrow County Grain Growers. Justin, I know you're in Orlando right now at the Polaris reveal, but get this ordered. However, we are not done.
Doing two.
We're doing two.
Oh.
We're going to do another RMK. Chaos slash.
Back to back.
We're going to go with the Patriot 9R.
Ooh, for this dang. One.
Next, and we're going to do the 15 by 146 with the 2.6 Series 6 truck.
Thought about this a little bit, huh?
Oh, yes.
Dreaming about it.
There it is. And same thing with this. We're going to go with the black. Tunnel black. Rail black. Next. Manual start, high elevation clutching. Wind deflector. Walker Evans, which those will be replaced by Fox as well. Low taper for RSI. We're going to do a 7S on that one as well. Next. And I guess we will do that same cover. Next. I am finished. Morrow County. I am 18. Submit. Boom. Oh, done. No.
You got two coming.
Dude. So, you know what we should do? We should order another one and just put Jeff's name on it.
I think we should.
Let's do it. Should we?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, boy. Snow check yours. Dude, Jeff's going to be pissed. Oh, should we get him?
Oh, 100% Chaos
Slash. The Chaos Slash?
Yep.
Boost. I know absolutely. He wants the boost.
I think he's going to like the 275.
Yeah, he'll probably be fine with that. 154. Oh, this is a part that I don't know for
what do you
him.
Think about colors?
Because I know that...
Is he a high-vis guy?
So he has a high-vis climb suit. But, I mean, I obviously would like to get a wrap for it as well. He did send me, when he was building it, he sent me a picture of this.
Yeah, that's a
so
good one.
Black and black. So here's what we're going to do is we are going to FaceTime him and confirm what colors he wants.
Okay, perfect.
Hopefully he answers. He probably knows why I'm calling.
Yeah, he probably does.
Oh, boy. Dude, I don't even know if the cameras are even still rolling. I know the big one
on
is.
That one.
So he snow checked his, I snow checked mine, and I just, we're building yours right now, calling to confirm colors. What colors do you want?
Did you snow check?
Shay. And then mine. Yeah, bro.
Said he wasn't going to.
Yeah, well.
When in Rome.
When in Rome. What colors did you like? Huh? Well,
that wasn't the question.
What colors did you like though? Because you only get black and gray, black and orange with the military tan, or the army green and neon and black, or the matte plum crazy and the radiant green. I mean, you're probably gonna wrap it, right? A special Sledson edition signature wrap. So do you want to just go all black? Moving on, boss. Yeah. Dude, I don't even know if our cameras are rolling anymore, Jeff. I don't know if our cameras are rolling anymore. Black Magic is. It's fine. We'll just cut it with the computer screen. It'll be fine.
What did you snow check already?
I snow checked a 155 boost and a 146 9R. Over $40,000 worth of snowmobiles.
Right.
Yeah. Maybe the title of this episode is going to be Tyler snow checks sleds and then gets divorced.
There you go. There you go.
Instead of
you might be able to put all that on there.
We'll just do sled send athletes, Tyler, Jeff, and Shay snow check, and all three end up in a divorce.
ISO bachelor pad.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, no.
He hung up. Oh, man. No, dude. Oh, bro.
Oh, he's not even going to answer
back. He won't answer this one, will he?
Oh, no.
What a punk, dude.
I think you still go through with it.
He'd probably come kill me.
He didn't even answer.
He won't answer.
Dang.
Saving your build. Oh, it's the cheapest one, isn't it?
Yep.
21,957. We can hold off on a cover for him. Next. I am finished. Oh, no. Jeff, congrats. You are the new future owner of a 2024 Patriot Boost RMK Chaos / 155.
Let's go.
Yeah.
It'll be fun. Fun next year for you, Jeff.
That sounds good, but I'm going to hold off because I know he'd be infuriated with yeah. me. And he plays an essential part in Sledson, so I can't piss him off too much.
Sledson splits due to snow check.
Yeah. But the good thing is we have until March 29th.
Yeah.
So
lots of convincing coming up in the next couple weeks.
Yep. So, well, gosh darn it. That was, wow. That was exciting.
Yeah. I mean, there's still quite a few good things, right, from it.
Yeah.
I like those scratchers. That's pretty cool. Nice to be able to look down and see your scratchers are still there after reversing it. But,
yeah.
The 325, sure. That's going to be... I hope I run into someone that. I guess I snow checked the 325. Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna like that. I think. We'll see.
Oh yeah.
Lug over length, as they say, right? That's what I've always heard. Lug over length, baby.
Yeah.
Don't need a 165.
That's funny. That's actually the first time I've heard that.
Yeah.
That's funny. So does that mean your current one's for sale then? No,
probably not.
No, you're gonna keep it as a backup.
Yeah, I gotta have one for my daughter to ride.
Well, hell yeah,
yeah, exactly.
Oh man, well, I think we're probably well beyond. Let's see, we started. Yeah, we're cutting in at an hour right now. So, I appreciate you guys listening to this episode. I know it was a little bit unorthodox listening to the videos on the computer and such. There wasn't a whole lot of talking. There was back and forth and whatnot. But yeah, we wanted to snow check some sleds live. And kind of give our reaction and our thoughts. I mean, again, like I, you know, we both didn't really think anything too crazy, but I mean, all good stuff. It's already a pretty good sled. So
Just fine tuning stuff.
So
I like it
because they run about what, like every 4 years, and then make a huge.
Change. I think last year we kind of got a little spoiled, right? Because we had the Patriot Boost right before that, and then boom, the 9R. Mm-hmm. And so this year, you know, we were kind of like, oh, man, at least I was, right?
Sure.
The expectation of a boosted 9R. But
yep.
3 years in a row just putting out new sleds, that would be pretty incredible. Yeah. Not to take anything away from Polaris. But
yep. Yeah, that'd be wild. So so we'll go ahead and wrap up this episode. Shay, thank you for jumping on. I think we should do a collective sled talk question. And I think that unless you have another one to ask,
I don't.
Which is fine, but I think we should collectively ask for you guys listening and watching, what did you guys snow check? Put in the comments below. We want to know, even if it's not Polaris, if it's something else. I know that Arctic Cat is opening up theirs tomorrow. So by the time we get this edited and get it out, what are you guys snow checking? Let us know. And then let us know why.
Yep, exactly. Too.
What are you snow checking and why? Cool. You got anything else to add?
No, I think that's it.
No?
Yeah. best of wishes. I hope no one actually does end up divorced due to these snow checks, but we do more time riding.
Heck yeah. Awesome. Well, Shay, thanks again for jumping on. Yeah, and listeners and watchers, thank you guys for being here, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.
Later, guys. 100K on the Patek Philippe, living life with no regrets. I can't design her when I get dressed. Hey. Summertime on winter fresh. Fresh. I put her legs behind her head. Night, night, she gonna bed. Bye-bye. Every day it's a new test. I just keep chasing these chicks.